Hi, and welcome to this section in the Learning C Sharp for Designers series, where we're going to be covering the topic of objects and classes, which is how we implement a more general idea that is called object-oriented programming. Object-oriented programming is one of the higher level and most common paradigms in all modern computer programming languages. Except, for example, for C, which is a bit more low level. And the idea is that it's a super, super powerful structure because it's able to represent more complex entities, more complex data representations than anything that we have seen so far. If you think about it, we've seen variables, which are a way of storing one data point, a Boolean, a number, an integer, a string, etc. Or we have seen also arrays and lists, which are ways of containing a collection of same type objects. So for example, a collection of numbers, a collection of strings, etc. But with objects and with classes, what we will be able to achieve will be to represent more complex entities. So objects that contain different types of variables inside of them, different types of functionality, so different types of functions inside of them, therefore being containers that pack a lot of information of different types, but also in a more abstract way, being representations of higher level ideas with particular instantiations of values inside of them. I'll get to what that means very soon in these videos. So what I would like to do in this section is I'm going to show you first a couple examples of what objects and classes look like and what they mean. Then I'm going to cover from a more conceptual, theoretical, if you will, standpoint, what classes are and their relation to objects. And then I'm going to cover all the basics of how to implement your own classes and your own objects from complete scratch. I will go over all the basics and a few advanced topics. I'm not going to get very far. I'm not going to talk about inheritance, polymorphism, or things that are a bit more advanced, because I think you can get away very far without these topics at a beginner level. And then I'm going to wrap up the section with a full-blown example where I'm going to implement a large class all from scratch. And I'm going to use that to reinforce the topics that I will explain in the videos, but also perhaps tease you with a few more advanced topics that I may not cover explicitly in the videos. All right, so shall we get busy? Let's see. I'll see you in the next video.